Welcome everyone to Monday Night Raw.
You know, each and every week here on Monday
we are
Night
here
Raw, we
in
make
Rio Rancho, New Mexico.
But I believe this week is looking like one of those legendary episodes we'll never ever forget.
All right, starting off with a tag team championship match. The Usos versus the Leaders of Worlds.
Hey Corey, have you been down since day one-ish?
Saxon, I've been down a lot longer than you have.
One of the great tag teams of all time.
Jimmy and Jay have been on a run recently that has redefined the tag team division in WWE.
Open your ears, Michael Cole. Things are about to get woken.
I will.
This is just dumb.
It's not dumb, Cole. It's woken.
How can you believe this is dumb?
It's the yin and the yang. It's the light and the dark. It's the leader of worlds.
Hey, Corey.
What?
You think I could be woken?
Absolutely not, Byron Saxton. You are an ignoramus.
I do have an idea, though,
what?
Byron.
What do you call me?
Go jump in the lake that Hardy has and never come out.
I can't swim.
That's the point.
On the way to the ring. At a combined weight,
you mean already in the ring?
79 pounds. Jey Uso and Jimmy Uso. The Uso. And their opponent, at a combined weight of 521 pounds, they are the Raw Tag Team Champions, Bray Wyatt and Matt.
What a night.
All right, so here we go.
The Uso Penitentiary is now open for business.
Wow.
Officer Jey Uso
both of them
is on
rushing
duty.
Towards Byron, each
we'll
other.
Meet the yard later.
Settle in, guys. This is going to be a blast to watch.
Jey Uso is so explosive in the ring, guys. He can hit you with a splash, slap on a devastating submission, or start a super kick party.
While he's dished out a few hangovers with his brother Jey Uso, he's more than capable of throwing a super kick party all by himself.
There may be no escaping this fireman's carry.
I don't know. Never say never, Cole.
Drop right onto the top turnbuckle.
Oh, hanging off for dear love.
Big time slam.
Vicious.
Oh, continuing to punish them.
Oh, I thought he was going for a camel clutch submission.
Many see him as one of the greatest champions of this era. Tonight is his chance to prove it. I think a lot
again
of people right now
move.
Are scratching their heads wondering how he let this match get so out of hand. Oh.
There's a tag, and I don't think this is going to be good for their opponent, Corey.
Absolutely not. Up they go. Incredible impact.
Incredible Samoan drop combo.
Byron calf crushers in.
Cinched in. Nowhere to go.
The champion would be incredibly embarrassing, especially considering all the trash talking I'm told has been going on behind the scenes. I don't want to reveal my sources, but let's just say there's been some pretty harsh words being tossed around.
Power slam! Irish whip!
I don't know who your sources are, Corey, but it wouldn't surprise me at all to learn that the champion has been a little cocky heading into this one.
And there's nothing wrong with that, Michael, especially considering just how dominant the champ has been of late. When you're that good, you have every right to bow your chest out a little bit.
And an easy kick out for Bray Wyatt. Tag made to Matt Hardy.
Oh man, right to the arm.
Hyperextend your elbow.
Oh my goodness, crushing it.
The challenger's taking on some offense.
The beauty of tag team competition is that he doesn't need to take the entire brunt of the opposition's attack. Though the thought of making a tag.
Side effect!
This might be.
Side effect from Matt Hardy, but. Oh yeah, I believe a two count there. Now Matt Hardy, the twist of fate.
Twist of fate!
In for the pin.
We've got a cover.
Pin's broken up.
But only a one count.
What a strike. What a stomp. Good grief.
Jey Uso
capable partner, he can tag
with a super kick.
He's back in control here.
His shoulders are down.
And the Usos, the new Raw Tag Team Champions.
Victory.
Yes.
If that match is any indication of what to expect here tonight, we are in for an amazing evening.
And that's the kind of action we've come to expect here on Raw. What an amazing match.
All right, well, up next we have one of the final Elimination Chamber qualifying matches, Nia Jax versus Ember Moon.
irresistible force is on Raw.
Making her way to the ring from San Diego, California, Nia Jax.
Of course, Nia Jax recently sort of becoming a team with Tamina.
Of the dominance that this woman is capable of.
She's beautiful, she's powerful, she's dangerous. It's like a million-dollar smile on a wrecking ball. Nia Jax is the irresistible force to be reckoned with.
Tamina and Sasha Banks obviously breaking up as a tag team.
Here comes the War Goddess. Her entrance is just as unique as her offensive playbook.
And now Ember Moon making her way to the ring. Ember Moon,
from Dallas, Texas, Ember Moon.
I believe she's never been the Raw Women's Champion in my universe mode.
It seems to me that these superstars want nothing more than to get their hands on one another.
WWE Hall of Famer Booker T discovered Ember Moon, and when I asked Booker what it was about Ember that attracted him to her, he said, "She's good."
She has proven to be good, an NXT Women's Champion in the past, certainly a future Women's Champion on Raw or SmackDown.
These competitors are squaring off looking to outmatch each other.
And of course I wonder if Carmella will make an appearance in this match. Since it seems like Ember Moon and Carmella having a bit of a
drop down,
a war with each other.
Nice. Oh, running FTO plant.
Nicely done.
Nothing fancy there.
She's taking out some offense here. She's going to need to find a way to mount an offense here. Ooh,
this is where we might just see one of these women pull away from the other for good.
Looks like she wants to
now
beat her
back into the ring.
Jax seems to have lost a step now. To be expected, though, given the competition she's in there with tonight.
If you're worried about her now, you haven't seen many of her matches. She can withstand so much more punishment than this.
But it's still early here, guys. It's going to take a whole heck of a lot more than this to keep her down.
Oh, man, what a strike!
She is on fire.
Keeping on with the stomps. Apparently, Nia Jax fighting back.
Down to the floor.
Oh, this is not good at all. Dodges that one. She's playing with fire here.
Yeah, she's got to hurry up and get back in there.
Knee drop!
That was nasty.
So precise.
She's looking a little unsteady. We're going to see what she's made of here, guys.
She's not looking so good here, guys. She's going to need to find a way to fend off some of this offense.
Now
and
the knee drop.
I just can't pick a winner at this point, guys. Any one of these women can take this thing.
Oh, nasty impact.
Nia Jax is really starting to fade now. She needs to find a way to get back on the offensive here.
These women are so evenly matched right now, guys. I can very easily see this match going either way.
This is going to be big, one way or another.
She wants to finish this.
She's tough, but nobody
moon top rope. For the eclipse, I believe that's called.
Great whip, shoulders down. Is it enough?
And Ember Moon with the win.
The pinfall and the victory.
Here is your winner, Ember Moon.
Kicking off the night with an impressive victory.
Yeah, the performance put forth in that match tells me we're looking at somebody who will someday, very soon, be competing in the main event.
What a way to kick off tonight. Don't go anywhere, folks. We're just getting started.
All right, well, a nice win for Ember Moon. Next up, another Elimination Chamber qualifier. Deonna Purrazzo versus Beth Phoenix.
Making her way to the ring, from Newark, New Jersey, the Queen.
I can't think of a better way to kick off this night.
I don't know. Part of me hoped Saxton would have gotten lost on the way to the announce table. That definitely would have made things better. But no such luck.
One of the best, most purest natural athletes we have ever seen in WWE.
Singles action is underway, and in this one, I wouldn't attempt to predict what's going to happen. I'd just be ready for anything. Sometimes that's all you can do.
And of course, Beth Phoenix, a legend in the wrestling world. Completely dominating Deonna Purrazzo so far.
Looking a little dazed here.
Yeah, she's definitely not looking herself right now, Cole.
Hurricanrana, ay Dios mio. Irish whip. Wicked clothesline.
She's starting to sweat a bit. Nothing she can't fire back from, though.
Pump the brakes a bit, Cole. I know exactly what you're thinking, and I can tell you with all certainty, she still has plenty of gas left in the tank.
At this point, I think it's fair to call into question her preparation for this match. She's clearly being outclassed right now.
Beautiful technique. Harsh impact. Leg drop.
And a leg drop by Deonna Purrazzo as she continues to beat down on Beth Phoenix.
Beth Phoenix, no problem getting out.
Gonna take more than that.
You've got to believe this one's over.
Now Beth Phoenix might be in trouble here. She doesn't want this lack of momentum to snowball.
You know, she's the kind of competitor that actually likes getting hit. It motivates her. And this might just be what she needs to put her over the top, believe it or not.
It's a torturous knee.
Monkey flip.
And that just dropped Beth Phoenix. Face first.
Now, looks like a... I thought that was a armbar submission, but...
I think we're about to see a Irish move from the top rope.
Wrenching on the arm.
Look out!
Top rope dive completely misses.
Uh-oh.
Now Deonna Purrazzo setting up for the finishing move.
Or a pump handle.
Pump handle suplex.
Incredible suplex. I knew it was only a matter of time.
Now in for the pin.
Shoulders are down.
And Deonna Purrazzo with the win.
And the victory. That may be the biggest win.
Hard not to agree with you, Cole.
Of course, Beth Phoenix going to show respect. Maybe. Yep.
And that's a great show of respect. Tremendous sportsmanship. Gotta love it.
All right, well, next up, it is our main event. A six-man Elimination Chamber qualifier. AJ Styles and Bad Influence, the team of Christopher Daniels and Kazarian, going up against the team of Adam Cole, Kyle O'Reilly, and Bobby Fish.
The phenomenal AJ Styles.
When you talk about AJ Styles, the list of accomplishments is seemingly endless. Styles, a true global superstar before arriving in WWE, but since he's been here, AJ Styles has lived up to the moniker, phenomenal.
Introducing first, from Gainesville, Georgia, weighing in at 218 pounds, the phenomenal AJ
AJ Styles has constantly proven that he is a mastermind of offensive innovation, and it has taken him to the championship promised land on multiple occasions.
I'm so glad to finally have the honor to call one of AJ Styles' matches. No one ever thought he'd ever make it here to WWE. But now, here the phenomenal one is, ready to compete on Raw. As we get ready to go here, Byron, I understand you've done a little research as it relates to these two teams.
Believe it or not, Michael, there are rumors circulating in the locker room that both these teams have issues when it comes to being on the same page. So it'll be interesting to see if that comes to fruition at some point here tonight.
The Undisputed Era is here. Cole, O'Reilly, and Fish, the most elite superstars in the entire world.
And their opponents, at a combined weight of 602 pounds, Adam Cole, Kyle O'Reilly, and Bobby Fish. The Undisputed.
Two-time NXT Tag Team Champions have arrived. Let's talk about the Undisputed Era. You're looking at a collection of some of the most successful internationally traveled superstars in all of sports entertainment. Now you add Roddy Strong to the mix, and they are as dominant as ever. to question if you've achieved worldly success in sports entertainment prior to...
Alright, so AJ Styles starting things off with Adam Cole.
This is a match that doesn't need a lot of hype or description.
Man.
Just look in the ring. This is going to be an incredible six-man tag match.
If you haven't hit record yet, now might be a good time to do that. These guys are going to have a match.
Of course, this is a Elimination Chamber qualifier. Three more spots open in the Elimination Chamber match for the Raw. The Universal Championship, that is.
Opponent off the ropes. Big backdrop.
Did Adam Cole's hair just like glitch out? That was weird.
This just ain't gonna do it.
I don't know what the referee was looking at there.
To me, like he had it locked in pretty good. I guess not.
He's
kind of looking at the ring apron.
He's up against Wolfpack down at any point during this match.
And I can tell you exactly what his partners are thinking right now. Why in the world did we agree to
tag major, Kyle O'Reilly.
Right there, Michael.
Of course, Kazarian tagged in. Kazarian needing to make the tag, maybe. And this is a normal six-man tag. No eliminations.
You only got to make your last shot count.
I kind of wanted to do an elimination match, but I don't think I could find a match type or anything. Unless I missed something though on how to do it.
He's got to hurry if he doesn't want to get counted out here.
Time's certainly not on his side, Michael.
Kazarian trying to get a count out. Kyle O'Reilly back in the ring.
Point of the elbow, nailed it. Bringing it back into the ring.
Safe to say that the action so far in this six-man tag team match is exactly what we expected.
Hey, you're gonna get hurt in a match like this. That's just the way it is. There's really no way around it.
The good news for him is that he doesn't appear to have taken too much offense up to this point, but that could obviously all change here.
Right down the end of the point of the elbow, right in the nose.
Jeez.
Almost there. And he tags his partner in.
Momentum has certainly shifted here, Michael.
Kyle O'Reilly steadying up.
Now Kyle O'Reilly.
He's got to capitalize now.
Submission hold here.
AJ Styles losing some grip here.
Styles has to get it together.
And AJ Styles might tap out.
Wolfpack down at any point during this match.
You know, there's an art to being a successful
AJ Styles able to get out of it.
Color me surprised, Michael. I did not see that one coming.
And the referee knocked out.
Trap the arm into the neck breaker.
Oh boy, he is rolling.
Oh my goodness, this hurts. Oh!
He's looking a little weary here. Rather than continuing to absorb any more punishment, he might want to tag out here.
At this point, he really has
now
to
take a calf crusher.
Bodies are not supposed to bend that way.
I believe it's called.
AJ Styles beginning to look, and he breaks free.
Just when you thought he was out of this one.
Tagged in.
Tag made to Adam Cole.
His partner wants it now.
Yeah, but it looks to me like he wants to do this himself.
Takes him down.
In a major way, too.
He's not in a good spot here, guys.
He simply needs to find a way to regroup.
And the steam will destroy your face. I think AJ Styles is done playing. He's looking at it. Nothing quite like the phenomenal forearm.
He hit it. This just might be enough for him to take the victory here.
This might be it. AJ Styles in for the pin. And AJ Styles and bad influence win. Amazing main event. Of course, that is it for Monday Night Raw, and I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you all next time.